Welcome back to the Education Roundtable. I'm Craig Petinak from San Bernardino Valley College. In our first segment, we talked a little bit about the theater arts program at SBVC. And in segment two, we're going to talk to two of the instructor's assistants in our culinary arts program. So I'd like to introduce you to Ian Weber and Lisa Walston. Thanks for being with us today.
Thank you for having us.
Ian and Lisa, you're both former students in the SBVC culinary arts program.
Correct.
What drew you to the program?
You know, I was told about it by my mom. She told me about it, and I've always had a passion for culinary. My aunt ran a catering company, and, you know, I decided, why not?
Okay. How about you, Lisa?
Mine just led from high school. I was taking a class, and I loved it. Teacher took us to the college to do a tour, and kind of fell in love.
So when you first came to the college and you first started taking classes, was it what you expected? Was it surprising? What do you remember about those first culinary arts classes?
I remember being extremely nervous about my first culinary classes.
Why?
I remember going and picking up the books and just having a book that was that big. And, oh my gosh, I gotta start reading this right now. And I was coming early every day and trying to stay late. And, just nervous.
Okay.
I think for myself, I was surprised, mainly because it wasn't like a kitchen in high school. It was an entire different atmosphere that I've never experienced before, but it was fun.
Okay. Have you always had, like, interest in the kitchen and kind of been around baking and cooking? And
ever since I was about 8 years old, my aunt and my mom used to use them as a punishment. You got to come in here and peel potatoes now. And in my head, I'm laughing at them. Like, I love to peel the potatoes. It's great. So.
Okay.
I kind of think mine started from working with grandma in the kitchen, making cookies and things like that, and it just went from there. High school classes, taking tours, and just kind of had the passion for it.
Okay, so you both graduated from SBVC culinary arts degree or certificates?
Myself, I have my certificate.
Certificate,
I haven't completed
okay.
my degree yet.
But now you're working as instructor's assistants. What does
yes.
that role mean?
For me, it means I'm in the back of the house with the students, getting hands in and actually showing them step by step how to make certain dishes.
And for me, I'm dining room, so serving and customer service.
Okay. What are some of the easiest ways to get started in culinary arts? Obviously, you can apply to the college and enroll in the courses, but there may be people at home who love watching the Food Channel, and they see celebrity chefs, and there's all this really popular stuff in the culture and on TV now. But does that really translate into the kitchen, into a culinary arts career? What are some of the advice to people you have that are watching this today?
I would say take the beginning course, the Introduction to Culinary Arts, because that basically introduces you to every aspect. Okay. Therefore, you'll get a grasp whether this is really for you or maybe not.
Okay.
I find a lot that the culinary shows on TV don't show what culinary arts really is. It's more than just bam in a pan, and it's a lot of hard work. You're on your feet a lot, so people out there should expect to work.
Okay, so what do you both expect to do? What are your dreams? What do you want to do with the knowledge you've gained now from the culinary arts program?
I plan to be a teacher. I want to come back and teach. I love teaching.
Okay.
That was not my general plan. Mine was to be an executive chef and have my own establishment.
Okay.
But after getting the job as the instructor's assistant and kind of having that role, it's starting to become a goal of mine as well. But I'm still uncertain.
Right. So in the culinary arts classes, how much of the instruction is like sitting over or standing over a stove or cutting up vegetables versus studying in a book and getting lectures? Like, is it a 50-50 mix?
It's more like a 90-10 to the cooking side.
Okay.
You spend a lot of time in the kitchen working with your hands and just getting in there with your knives and going to work.
So part of the going to work is that you're getting to create some really cool things, some really tasty things. And I understand that you have some samples that you brought just for the show today. Is that correct?
We did.
Excellent. Let's see what we've got here. Look at that.
Thank you, Alex.
What are we staring at here? Tell us about this.
What we have here are three pedophores.
Pedophores?
Yes,
okay.
They're miniature cakes.
Okay.
Okay. Here we have a caramel and peanut butter. we have a standard buttercream, and we have a chocolate ganache. They're all white cake with almond extract in them. They're
okay. Really nice. Now, you talk about that as if maybe you had a hand in making them.
I actually did have a first hand in making them. I made them this morning.
Okay. Well, would it be okay if I took a taste of that?
Please, please.
All right. You recommend this one here?
That's the one I do.
All right, okay. Let's try this. All right. Ready? We're going to try it, see how it goes. Mmm. Mm-hmm. I taste the peanut butter.
Yeah.
That's really good. That's really good. So how long did it take you to make this?
This was about an hour and a half.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. Wow. So if there's people in the audience who are looking at this and they're dribbling on themselves because it looks really good, do they get a chance to try some of these things? Where can they see some of your creations and get a taste of it for themselves?
Well, we do have a restaurant on campus called The Sunroom. We're open 3 days a week,
okay.
Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, from 11 to 1:15.
And you only serve sweet things like this, right?
No.
Okay, tell us, what are some of the things that you serve? What are some of those popular dishes?
One of our most popular dishes is a braised beef short rib pasta. It is braised beef ribs that we marinate in a red wine sauce, and we sit in the oven, and it sits there for about an hour and a half, so until it's nice and tender, and then we toss it with a little bit of butter and cream and just all the good stuff in life and serve it up.
So you're open from Mondays to Wednesdays, 11 to 1:15,
yes.
Is that right? At the Sunroom on the Valley College campus.
Yes.
Excellent. And you can call ahead, you can call orders in, make reservations for parties, all
excellent.
That good stuff.
Excellent. Well, Lisa, Ian, thank you so much. Thank you for the treats.
You're very welcome. You enjoy those.
Thank you. I will. As soon as that camera goes off, especially. And we'll be right back with our third segment on Education Roundtable. Stay with us.